Okay, we're on the other side. Let me zoom back out. We're on the other side. They're started to, nothing else they can do with them. So what they're doing, they're cutting these cars up. This is actually a part of the engine, the power unit of the train, cooling units, engines and stuff. And that's one of the locomotives that was involved that they've already cut into pieces. There are some, the tank car that they have cut on already. Anyway, so sorry about the fading light, but here we are back on this side. You can see that one engine that was burned, that's it right here. This is the first one I showed you from the other side. And the front end on it is quite damaged. The second one in the row, I'll get up here a little bit further and show you, kind of show you how it's been in. Like I said, that's the, past the firehouse here. That is the bent end front on it. There's the front end of the engine that you couldn't see all of it. It's pretty well mangled. I've been over actually to it. And let's see. You can see that the guardrails and walkway rails and stuff on the front are fairly bent up. I'm going to pan around here. This is a hopper car that was mangled up. I don't know if you can see that from... Anyway, just one of the cars. I'm kind of rushing through this because I'm losing my light. It's evening time. This is what looks like another hopper car here. That, I don't know if you can see or not, that, you can see the rail, that's a window opening, that's actually a part of the cab of one of the engines. You'll understand better in a few minutes. Like I said, this is a hopper car that was full of probably that stinking feed that's out here. These did not wind up in this area. That's not a part of it. They stuck them over here out of the way. That is a tank car that has been ripped and finished cut in half that they're gonna have to rip up. And anyway, let me get back over the other side. I'll get back on here.